Hello and welcome to Last Week in Wonderland. This is the first episode to a new series in which we will discuss what happened in the previous week. Obviously, to start off with, this is unscripted. However, I do have guidelines in which I will talk through. This way, I think it's just easier to record this way. I say that, but this is the third recording, and it is the furthest I've gotten. So, we'll see how it goes. To sort of begin, I want to talk about the background of Andrew Tate. As the first segment of this episode is, Andrew Tate was arrested. I know, Top G was taken. The Matrix has struck, you could say. But I want to start by going into the background of Andrew Tate. Andrew Tate was a kickboxer. However, he got very big on TikTok, and it was very quickly he got big. And I'd never seen a single video he posted himself, which was interesting. It was always other people posting videos of him. And now these videos would vary from incredibly based, 100% truths, usually his reference to women, to the most barbaric things you could possibly hear a man say. And that was the very interesting thing about Andrew Tate, is just how much of an arsehole he is. Like, he is a dick. But I think that adds to his sort of, I think that's why so many people like him. You see, Andrew Tate was, I suppose you'd call him a right wing. He was very sort of pro-masculinity, which I guess is right wing now. It used to just be normal, but that is, I suppose, right wing now. And he would often talk about how men need to sort of strengthen themselves and sort of take responsibility for their own lives. Very, very respectable things. And he'd often talk about women, where he'd say that women are supposed to be virtuous, sort of embrace chastity, which a lot of women didn't like. Obviously, most of them are whores, so they didn't like it. But to sort of expand from what he posted, it was really, he was really a symbol of men being sort of self-help. That's a very common thing now, actually, with sort of men being taught barbaric things from schools that you're not supposed to be masculine, very silly sort of beliefs that are sort of imposed on men. And as a result, you get people like Andrew Tate who say the opposite, who say you should be masculine, you should be powerful. And obviously they get big. It's very Jordan Peterson sense of sort of philosophy he was sprouting. Andrew Tate, he has a brother called Tristan Tate. He will be mentioned later as they are both arrested. But Andrew Tate then later, he said something very cool about Islam. And it was that, it was less about Islam and more about religion, to be honest. That unless you follow every part of your religion, you are not a part of that religion. And he's recently backtracked that, but I know a lot of people attacked him for that. I personally completely agreed with him. But Andrew Tate has recently become a Muslim. He did this because it is the only religion that doesn't get mocked. Which, there's quite a bit to that. After all, when a French teacher mocked it, he was beheaded, you know, when if I mock a Christianity, that's going to happen. So he was absolutely correct in that. I wasn't the biggest fan of him becoming Muslim, though we'll sort of talk about my complaints about him at the end of this segment. Moving on to the sort of the full background of his arrest, we have a tweet here by Andrew Tate, in which, now, okay, I'm going to clarify, the tweet, below Greta Thunberg's is the original. I hate how Twitter works. The thing you read first should be on the top, not the bottom. It's a terrible system. I don't know why Elon Musk hasn't changed it, but moving on. Andrew Tate makes a tweet in which he says, "Hello at Greta Thunberg." Thunberg. I always thought it was Thunderberg. A lot less cool than I thought it was. Anyway, I have 33 cars. My Bugatti has a W16 8.0L quad turbo. I have no idea what that means. I'm not really into cars. And my two Ferraris, 812 right, we're going to ignore that part. This is just the start. He's basically saying he has a lot of cars and they have a lot of emissions. Please provide your email address so I can send a complete list of my car collection and their respective enormous emissions. Greta, upon receiving this tweet, was furious. Anger. She was so furious, she had to turn the heating on. I know. It was outrageous. So Greta responded with, "Yes, please do enlighten me. Email me at smalldickenergy@getalife.com. Now, to sort of preemptively say, I don't think that's a real email. I might be wrong, but I think emails have to have @email.com at the end. I don't think getalife is the correct one. But moving on from that, what Greta Thunberg has effectively done is admitted to having, not only having a cock actually, given she is a woman, well, I say that, you can never know nowadays, but she has admitted to having a small dick, which is, it's not really something you should be doing, but I guess it worked, it did work. People did in fact side with Greta Thunberg, which I didn't entirely understand. I mean, Andrew didn't really make a punch at her, so it wasn't really an attack on Andrew's part, but Greta inflicted a self-wound, which frankly just tells me she lost even worse than Andrew could have. However, Andrew did make a respond. In this tweet he says, "Thank you for confirming via your email address that you have a small penis, at Greta Thunberg. The world was curious, and I do agree you should get a life." Now, it was a good response. It was a good response. He pulled a reverse you Uno card. It was an astounding response. But it did come with a video, and I'll let that video play now.
Release some greenhouse gases. I'm obviously a stranger to online controversy. It's not something I often do. But now, the mainstream press is commenting on the fact that I was informing Greta that my very extensive car collection with internal combustion engines, which run on dead dinosaurs, have an enormous emission profile. And she replied by telling me her own email address. Greta's email address is, "I have small dick energy." Why would that be your own email address, Greta? Strange. I mean, also, I don't want to assume her gender. It's 50-50, but it is what it is. I'm not actually mad at Greta. Please bring me pizza and make sure that these boxes are not recycled. Thank you. So I'm not actually mad at Greta, right? Because she doesn't realize she's been programmed. She doesn't realize she's a slave of the Matrix. She thinks she's doing good. Someone has sat her down and convinced her to try and convince you to beg your government to tax you into poverty to stop the sun from being hot. And then, because I called her out on it, the global matrix got this bot farm to like and retweet and all this bot commenting to try and pretend that her telling me that she has a small dick and her own email address somehow teaches me a lesson. Welcome to a new episode of The Clown Show. But now I know, at least, that Greta, with a little hate-filled face, bitter, sitting somewhere without the heating on, in the cold, a little hat, shivering, views my tweets, which is going to make my Twitter account far more fun into eternity.
He's such a dick, isn't he? Like, he was so cocky, and honestly, love that video. But there was something you probably noticed, and so did the Romanian police. He brought pizzas on. Now, apparently, those pizzas had the address of a specifically Roman company. A Romanian company. Now, the police used that company to identify where he was, and they arrested him. I have an article here that I'm going to read a little bit out of. I know, the more things change, the more they stay the same. Andrew Tate, Romanian police to halt influencer. I wouldn't say he's an influencer. I'd probably mention the fact that he's a kickboxer. I think that is his official profession, but wouldn't a bit dodgy about that. For 30 days. Yes, they are holding him for 30 days. Let's read a little bit of it. The controversial British-American influencer hates that. British-American, just say British or American. Which one is he? Is interesting. Born in America, has a bit of an English accent. I don't understand it either, but moving on. Andrew Tate will be held in detention in Romania for 30 days after a court agreed to a police request. Tate was arrested alongside his brother Tristan on Thursday as part of an investigation into allegations of human trafficking and rape, which they deny. There was also another charge. There were three in total. It'll probably be included later, but I think the other one was organised crime. Authorities suspect the pair, along with two Romanian men, of running an organised crime group. Okay, so they do mention that that's also one of the charges, but they don't mention it was a charge, just mention that was why they were arrested. Tristan and two others were also detained by police in Bucharest. Outside the court, the Tate's lawyer, Eugene Vidiniac, said they would appeal against the detention. We are not at a stage where guilt or innocence is proven for now. We only discuss preventative measures, he added. Mr. Vidiniac told the BBC his clients rejected all the allegations. Andrew Tate, 36, has yet to comment directly on the accusation. Well, he is in prison, so I'd imagine he'd be pretty hard to. But after being detained, a tweet was sent from his account, from his Twitter account, alluding to the 1999 movie The Matrix. The Matrix sent their agents. The post said, the account also retweeted Matrix memes posted by Twitter owner Elon Musk. Now, this is something I want to discuss. I want to sort of ask, how did that tweet happen? Now, I'm not an expert on Romanian prisons, but I can't imagine they'd let you have your phone in prison, which sort of tells me that there was an external play or person at play, somebody else who made the tweet, or you genuinely can't just have phones in prison in Romania, which seems like a weird thing to allow. The Matrix. There was a famous video by Andrew Tate that he said that you get three chances. The first is you are cancelled, then you are prisoned, and then you are killed. He said this is how the Matrix, as he calls it, works. Obviously, he was cancelled, he's in prison, kind of tells you what he's expecting next. But moving on, during the detention hearing, the two brothers maintained their right to silence, their lawyer told the BBC. Earlier, police spokesperson told the BBC that the 36-year-old would be held at a detention centre. On Thursday night, Romania's for investigating organised crime and terrorism issued a statement, but did not name the Tate brothers, stating that two British citizens and two Romanian citizens were suspected of being part of human trafficking. Police alleged the victims were recruited by the British citizens, this would be Andrew Tate and Tristan Tate, who they said had misrepresented their intention to enter a relationship with the victims, which it called the Loverboy method. I've never heard of that method in my life. I'd imagine it's a problem in... I mean, if it happens so much that there's a term for it, it'd have to be pretty common in Romania. They were later forced to perform in pornographic content under threat of violence, the statement alleged. Now, this is a very interesting thing, because this is very hard to prove. You would actually need... If you were forced to do it, and it's been so long now, because I wouldn't imagine this happened yesterday. If it did, then there'd be more credibility. But for it to happen so long ago, that it's pretty hard to prove. Especially since this isn't the first time Andrew has been accused of this, and in all the previous times, he was found innocent. A picture has split up the article in two, so we're actually going to stop reading there. Now, I think that gives a proper sort of in-depth look into... sort of, well, at least the media's representation of it, as the BBC is obviously a very sort of biased news source, which is not what they're supposed to be, but that's a topic for a different day. Something I sort of want to mention that I haven't seen anybody else mention is why the pizza box? It proved no point to the video, but had so much emphasis focused on it, and it's led to such a drastic sort of conclusion. I mean, it led to his arrest. But it was such a weird and frankly unnecessary part of the video, which has led me to question, why was it even added in the first place? I don't have an answer. It is genuinely just a question on my end. Before we move on to discussing my personal problems with Andrew Tate, I want to go to sort of move back, as I've just realised I've completely forgot half of what I was going to say. Back to the tweets in question. A lot of people were siding with Greta. They said, oh, she's owned him. Again, I don't see how you could think that unless you didn't already dislike Andrew Tate and are just looking for an excuse. But I wanted to focus more on a specific response by a certain Hassan Abi trying to beef with... Oh, sorry, I'll read Andrew's first. Andrew's original response to the tweet was, "How dare you?" Pretty normal, not really much meaning to it. But Hassan Abi responded with, "Trying to beef with teenagers instead of adults and still losing is wild." Now, not only does Hassan sort of assume that he lost, which he didn't, but he also says, "Trying to beef with teenagers instead of adults." Greta is 19 years old, a legal adult in every single country on Earth. I don't understand. I'm going to say I don't understand why Hassan is trying to play it as if she's a child. I do. It's obviously to make him look worse. But I don't understand how Hassan could defend that, because it's blatantly not true and is purely trying to paint a narrative that not only did Andrew lose, which, again, he didn't, but that he was fighting a child, obviously to make it look even more pathetic that he lost. None of it was true. Well, I suppose the teenager part was true, since 19 is still technically a teen, even though it's on the verge. It's on the verge, you know. You can vote at that age, so whether you want to call it a teenager or an adult, I'd argue it's both. But I did just want to focus on this, because I feel it is the sort of greater sort of response from what we're called the left, is to sort of just jump on this and to try and make it look as bad as possible. Which obviously they would do. Andrew Tate is somebody who sort of tries to build men up and is hardly a feminist. So it would stand to reason that they would oppose him in any way they could. And this is merely the way they found that's most advantageous to them. Now, before I start digging in on Andrew, I do think he's innocent. I don't think he did it. I think it is genuinely just people trying to sort of shut him up. But now that that's sort of out of the way, I'm not a big fan of the Top G. Obviously, I love the memes. I love a lot of what he says is true, right? If not most of what he says is true. But I do have some sort of problems with him. First is that he claims to sort of want men to build themselves up, and then he runs a prostitution company, which is literally profiting off of men ruining their lives. The contradiction is, I think, is very blatant there. Now, you could argue that the men are consenting, but still, you're effectively a drug dealer at that point, and that's not really something good to be. So I don't like him for that one. And there was also a tweet I saw in which he mocked a man whose son was dying. He mocked him because he couldn't afford healthcare. Pretty dodgy stuff. That is not a very... It's just uncalled for. And I think it really left a really bad taste in my mouth. So I'm not the biggest fan of Top G, but I do think what he says in most of his videos is completely correct. I like the message he sends. I don't like him as a person. Low, again, watching that video, you can't help but love him. You can't. It's just the blatant smugness. It just adds to your character. It's just like Donald Trump. He was such a jerk, you had to love him. And I think Andrew Tate very much has that same quality about him. But to sort of wrap up the end of this segment, I do think he's innocent. I think he'll probably be found innocent. I can't imagine they'd get arrested for that. But who knows? Who knows? I mean, frankly, they got the guy for George Floyd arrested, so who knows? And that's all the end of this segment. The next segment is... The government killed Kanye West. I'm joking. They didn't. Hopefully they didn't, but he has gone missing. And now, to sort of start this one off, I want to do very similar to the way I did Andrew Tate. We're going to go into the background of Kanye West, sort of my knowledge before him. Now, I understand he was a rapper. I didn't like much of his music. There was one or two songs. I liked No Church in the Wild. I liked that one. But other than that, wasn't a big fan of his music. But I did like his politics. He ran for president, and I think it was a great thing. Ran for president, and he did very well, actually. He did very well, in fact. He got like 600,000, well, but he got like 6,000 votes, which, considering he was running as an independent, is very good. I personally supported him in the election. This was obviously the election that Biden won. Did used election fraud to cheat Kanye West out of victory. Should have won. This was obviously that election, and I was a really big fan of Kanye. I thought it is the future America needed. But he didn't win. Though we did get one vote in Wyoming, which, I mean, the rest is funny. The rest are funny. But that one man in Wyoming voting for Kanye West, that is amazing. That man is a legend. We need to find him and we need to congratulate him. But obviously, no good Titan stands forever. And just as every god fell, so too has Kanye West. Man likes Hitler. Hates the Jews, loves Hitler. He just says it. Now, I do want to actually take note of what the original claims were. Well, I think, yeah, we'll go on with the original claims. The original claims was that he was going to go DEFCON 4 or 5 or 3. It was one of them. I don't know the reference. On Jews. Now, he says deaf. Apparently, he's ADHD, so he didn't actually mean deaf. He meant depth or something along those lines. But he also claimed anti-Semitic because black people are actually Jew. Also, you guys have toyed with me and tried to blackball anyone who ever opposes your agenda. I don't know what that means. It's all just foreign to me. But he said it. Now, obviously, this alone got everyone terrified. But then he expanded further on what he truly meant. Kanye West claimed that the genocide against black babies was worse than the Holocaust, and he used abortion to support this. Now, I do agree with this claim. It is true that more black people have been killed as a result of abortion than the Holocaust. That is true. But then he started supporting Hitler, which is when I sort of took back and said, oh, yeah, you're kind of on your own here, mate. It was sort of, he did start with truth. And then he went on, I think it was, InfoWars, that's it. Yes, he went on InfoWars. And while on InfoWars, he said some pretty dodgy stuff. Now, the thing I found funny was that when I think of sort of Alex Jones, I think of a man who will not be shaken by anything. And then Kanye West came on, and you could see the horror in the man. He didn't know what to do. You could see the horror in his face. He was stunned. And Kanye West says some pretty spicy things. Now, to sort of move on to the consequences of Kanye West praising Hitler, my man got banned from Twitter. Elon Musk banned him for inciting violence. Now, I haven't seen the sort of tweets in which he would incite violence, but I mean, obviously, if you're banned him, then I can't see a tweet, but I don't believe he would have. I think it was probably wrong for him, for Elon, to get rid of him, but I mean, it's his company, and he can kind of do what he wants. That was very wrong of him. He's still got Instagram, though, which is interesting. The free speech-loving Elon Musk banned him, but Instagram let him stay. And that is very interesting. But he also lost his bank account. I know. It's funny, that, isn't it? Go against the... Say something wrong about the Jews, you lose your bank account. Very funny. Very funny. All of Western media dragged his name through the mud. Maybe justifiably... He did side with Hitler. Maybe it wasn't really justifiable. But the thing I want to sort of notice on is the backlash wasn't just towards him, but I saw a lot of videos of black men in just America just saying, like, we hate the Jews. And it was very interesting just how much sort of this sentiment sort of stuck in black communities. And I think that's something that doesn't get spoken about nearly enough, is that it was very sort of... It's not a secret that black people don't like other people in America. There were conflicts with the Koreans. They don't like a lot of white people in their neighborhoods. It's a very sort of well-known thing in America. Even if the media do try to hide it. Obviously, I mean, who do you think was doing the Asian attacks? But anyway, so it is very interesting to see that the sentiment has really sort of invoked a lot of... But I suppose, actually, you could argue the sentiment has invoked a lot of incitement towards violence against Jews. though I don't think he should have been banned for it. You can argue that actually did happen. But to sort of go back against the two, not against, but to go back to the sort of consequences towards Kanye, he was dragged through the mud. All the celebrities left him. It did look as if he was sort of being controlled, someone was trying to control him, as he did say, there was tweets released that somebody threatened them, saying that they will come for you or something along those lines, and then obviously he posted them on, I think it was Instagram, and that got exposed, which was very interesting, the idea that somebody's controlling the sort of Hollywood elites. Well, not really elites, sort of just the Hollywood people, is a very interesting thing. And I wish he sort of expanded more on that, but unfortunately we have yet to see that sort of get expanded on. This whole thing eventually led to the disappearance of Kanye West. Now, to sort of go into this, I think it's probably best if you rely on sort of a source of authority, the Daily Mail, only the most holy and truthful sources of authority I could find. We're going to go through an article. The title is Kanye West's former business manager complains he can't locate the disgraced star to serve him with court papers in $4.5 million lawsuit, sparking wild rumour that the rapper is missing. Now, the reason I chose this article, and there was a lot of articles, but this is the one I chose, because of the way it's said. It said it is a wild rumours. It does say it's a baseless accusation later on, but it also calls him a disgraced star. It's coming off very, very sort of emotional, sort of as if it's trying to get you to think something instead of just telling you the truth. And I think that's very interesting, because obviously we've just done Kanye West, not Kanye West, but Andrew Tate, and the sort of people getting him arrested. So I do like the idea of, and we did just speak about, you know, handlers in Hollywood getting people to sort of stay in line. So I think it is interesting that this is sort of the way that the Daily Mail have chose to report on this, as if it is stupid and outrageous to even think this is a possibility, while also talking negatively about him. But remember, he is a Hitler fan, so I mean, you can't exactly talk too positively about him. Regardless of how good Graduation may have been, you can't think too positively about him. We'll sort of go into the article here. We won't go too far into it, as frankly, there's so many adverts, I don't think I could. Kanye West, former business manager, has claimed in court that he's been unable to properly serve the troubled rapper with court documents in a $4.5 million lawsuit, sparking unfounded rumours that Kanye West has gone missing. Thomas St. John, who is suing West in Los Angeles. See, I don't like that his surname's West, because I thought that was a place. Over alleged unpaid fees, told the court that he's unable to find his proper address. In the December 19 filing seeking a time extension to serve the paper, St. John said that West did not appear to have an attorney to accept them on his behalf, and noted that attempts to mail the document to the three personal addresses had failed. Although West was spotted in public just days before St. John filed his court complaint, it nevertheless sparked wild rumours that the erratic star was missing. The claim went viral on social media, apparently based on a tweet from the hip-hop commentary account Daily Loud, which read, Kanye West has reportedly been missing and unable to find sick for weeks, according to his ex-business manager. Now, that's as far as I'll go. Now, this could very well just be nothing. He could just be trying to not pay the thing. And chances are, that's probably what this is. That's probably what's actually happening. But let us not sort of dismiss the idea that he has, in fact, gone missing. Specifically because when he was seen last, it was with a mask on. And it was to drop his daughter off somewhere. I'd imagine it was school, though I can't find any evidence of it was. It was church. It was church. He dropped his daughter off to church. I'd imagine they stayed there together. But he did have a mask on. Now, this is very interesting, the fact that he's hiding his identity in public and has then gone missing. after talking about handlers in Hollywood, to see how sort of the narrative forms on its own. And I think it's a real possibility that somebody is trying to shut him up. And for this to happen at around about the same time Andrew gets arrested, it is a coincidence. It is probably a coincidence, but it could be more. That's actually about all I have for the episode. The arrest of Andrew, and the disappearance of Kanye. I do hope you enjoyed this episode of Last Week in Wonderland. And I hope to see you next week. That's about it. Ciao.